Okay students, now we are going to discuss the equations of uniformly accelerated motion. So our first equation is v is equals to u plus at. So let us see how this equation has been derived. We already see, for example, consider an object like car. Okay, consider one car and it is moving with some initial velocity u. Okay, so after traveling for time t seconds, its velocity will be changed to final velocity, let it be v. Okay, so when any body is changing its velocity, that body undergoes some acceleration. So let it be that acceleration is a. Okay, so already we have studied what is acceleration definition, rate of change of velocity. So now acceleration is equals to what is that? Change in velocity. What is acceleration? Change in velocity by time taken, isn't it or not? Nothing but change in velocity minus, we know what is change in velocity, final velocity minus initial velocity by time taken, isn't it or not? Then what is final velocity in our condition? V. And what is initial velocity? U. And what is time taken? T. And A is equals to V minus U by T. Okay, so now here T is under division. So if I am bringing this side, it will become AT is equals to V minus U. Then here I am bringing U this side, U plus AT is equals to V. So after writing from here to there, finally I got V is equals to U plus AT. This is the first equation for uniformly accelerated motion. Once again I am explaining, see children, consider one object is moving and let its initial velocity will be u. After traveling for time t seconds, its velocity becomes v. So when there is a change in velocity, that body undergoes some acceleration. So finally A is equals to, we already studied, isn't it or not, acceleration is equal to rate of change of velocity. When there will be a change in velocity, then only that body will have acceleration. So definitely this body will have acceleration. So A is equals to change in velocity by time taken. So change in velocity means nothing but final minus initial, final velocity minus initial velocity. So we know that values, what is that? Final velocity v and initial velocity u. So finally A is equal to v minus u by t. So after rearranging, finally we got v is equals to u plus at. So this is the first equation, clear? So now I am going to explain second equation. What is the second equation? So now I am going to explain about the second equation, that is s is equal to ut plus half at square. Here also same, we will consider one object, okay, like car moving with some initial velocity. After traveling for t seconds, let its velocity changes to final velocity v, and acceleration undergoes acceleration also, let it be a. So in this case we are going to calculate s. What S stands for? Distance. Yes, S stands for distance. So if we want to calculate the distance of an object, so that time we will use this equation. So let us see how this equation has been derived. Okay, already we don't have any equation for finding distance. Only we know that speed is equal to distance by time taken. Isn't it or not? We have studied in previous class, speed is equal to distance by time taken. From this, can I write distance is equal to speed into time? Yes, we can write, isn't it or not? Speed is equal to distance by time, we know. So from that I have written distance is equal to speed into time, isn't it or not? Time I know, what is the time? T. Time we know, but for calculating speed, what? For calculating speed for calculating distance, I want speed or not? Yes. So how we will calculate speed in this case? Speed is equals to, we don't have any formula here. So speed is equal to, I am calculating average speed. What I am calculating? Average speed. Here how many average speed is already we know. What is average speed? Final speed plus initial speed by number of quantities. How many cases we are taking? 2 cases. So final speed plus initial speed by 2. So here what is the final speed? V. What is the initial speed? U by 2. So average speed we got how much? V plus U by 2. Even nothing but in case of speed even we can write velocity also. So average velocity is equal to V plus U by 2. Okay. So now here I got it average velocity. See here. From here only I am writing distance is equals to average velocity into time. Nothing but speed or average speed, both are same. So in case of speed I am writing here average speed or average velocity, both are same. So already this value we found out. What is that value? V plus U by 2 into what is time taken here in our case? T. Okay, so T. So this is our distance. Distance is equal to V plus U by V plus U by 2 into T, or S is equal to V plus U by 2 into T. Clear up to here? After that, see here, is there anywhere V is there here? Final velocity is mentioned here? No, not mentioned. But in our expression, we got final velocity V. So this V should be eliminated from here. How can we eliminate this V from here? We can eliminate this V by using this first equation. What is the first equation? Already we have found out V is equal to U plus AT. Isn't it or not? Let it be this is 1. Let it be this is 2. Now substitute this V value in 1. Understood? Substitute 2 in 1. Clear? Have a look here. So substitute 2 in 1. So now finally we got S is equals to in place of. So substitute 2 in 1. So now we will get S is equal to in place of V, we will get U plus AT. Okay. U plus AT plus what is left here? 1 U is left here. Okay. And in denominator we are having 2 into T. Okay. Then S is equal to U plus U. 2U plus A into T, AT by 2 into T. Then finally we get, we will multiply 2U into T, 2UT plus AT into T, AT square by 2. Now I am separating 2UT by 2 plus AT square by 2. This 2 will get cancelled and finally we got S is equal to UT plus this 2 I am bringing just front. So I am writing separately as half into AT square. Nothing but this is our second equation. S is equals to UT plus half AT square. Clear children? Here like same case we are doing. We are considering one object moving with some initial velocity u, and after traveling for time t seconds it got final velocity v. Whenever there is change in velocity, that body will undergo some acceleration, isn't it? So in this case we are going to calculate the how much distance that object has been covered. So for calculating this distance we are using formula that speed is equal to distance by time. But here distance by time, from this I have written distance is equal to speed into time. Speed is equal to final speed plus initial speed by 2. So already we know V plus U by 2. So here again this one I am using here. So distance is equal to, in place of speed I am writing average speed or average velocity, no problem, into time. So average velocity already we have found. What is that? V plus U by 2 into time means into T. So distance is equal to same we got into T, but here we have to eliminate V. Why? Because there is no V in our equation, isn't it or not? So in place of V I am writing U plus AT. So after that writing here, see, in this place of V I am writing U plus AT. After that U plus U, 2U AT by 2 into T. Again I have multiplied with 2 both the terms, 2u into t, 2ut, at into t, at square by 2. So I have separated 2 terms, so 2 gets cancelled here. Final I got ut plus at square by 2. So final I got s is equal to ut plus half I have written separately, half into 80 square. This is our second equation of uniformly accelerated motion. So now I am going to start the third one, v square is equal to u square plus 2as. Simple, nothing is there here, just here also we will use the second equation. What is that? Ut plus half at square. Okay, here what you have to do, the thing is, here you have to remove the t. See here in our third equation, is there time quantity here? No. So we have to remove this t from this equation. If we will remove that t, we will get that one. So let us see how we can remove. For this one also we will use this first one. What is the first equation? V is equal to u plus at. So v minus u is equals to at. This u I have sent that side. So v minus u by a. This a I am bringing this side. So this is t value, nothing but. Isn't it or not? So this t value I am going to substitute. Let it be this is 2. Let it be this is 1. So substitute 2 in 1. Okay, so s is equal to u into what is t value? V minus u by a plus half into a into v minus u by a whole square. Just I have substituted c t value. Then uv into u into v uv minus u into u u square by a plus half into a into a minus b whole square. What is a minus b whole square? A square plus b square minus 2ab. Isn't it or not? So v square plus u square minus 2vu by, for a also square is there, so a square. So this a I am writing a into a. So 1a will get cancelled. So uv minus u square by a plus 1 by 2a into v square plus u square minus 2vu. Okay, yeah, already I brought here, see. So now take LCM. What will be the LCM? 2a. So these two will be multiplied here. 2 into uv, 2uv minus 2 into u square, 2u square plus, this is as it is, v square u square minus 2vu. Clear? So after that, 2a. So that is equals to, which one is equal to? S is equals to plus 2uv minus 2uv will get cancelled, isn't it or not? So S is equal to v square. See here, minus 2u square plus u square. Minus 2 plus 1, how much? Minus 1. So minus 2u square plus u square, how much? Minus u square by denominator 2a. So I am sending this 2a here. So I am getting 2a s is equals to v square minus u square. I am sending minus u square that side. So it will become plus u square. Plus u square plus 2a s is equal to v square. So finally we are getting v square is equal to u square plus 2a s. So this is our third equation. Simply what we have done? Just we have eliminated t from the second equation. For removing that t, which one we have used? First equation we have used. What is that first equation? V is equal to u plus at. From that I got t value, t is equal to v minus u by a. After substituting in t place that value, see here v minus u by a, here also square. Already after simplifying all those things, finally we got v square is equal to u square plus 2as, third equation.